Police are not expected to file charges in a deadly shooting, but the case is not closed.
Joshua Cowles was shot inside his Valley Station home Tuesday morning. WLKY's Marissa Alder talked with a man that was at the home at the time of the shooting. She's live outside of police headquarters with the latest developments. Marissa.
Rick, detectives here chose not to take anyone into custody, but instead turned the case over to the Commonwealth Attorney's Office for review. I talked exclusively with one of the witnesses to get a better idea about why.
I was asleep, and I guess probably around 4 a.m., there was some very, very loud arguing and screaming going on. And it lasted a little bit, and then I ended up falling back asleep because it just stopped. Everything went quiet. And then I guess 2 hours later, I woke back up and heard the arguing again. And then I heard 3-4 gunshots.
WLKY caught up with recording artist Buckshot as he returned to the studio. 2 days ago, his roommate, Joshua Cowles, known as Gotti, died inside their home in the 5700 block of Alicante Lane in what appears to be a domestic incident.
I mean, I didn't know who was shooting, or I didn't know the situation. I just knew gunshots, and I pushed my dresser in front of the door, and I kind of got low to the ground and was just kind of listening. Everything went quiet for a second. Then I heard his girlfriend screaming that he'd been shot. And then I poked my head out.
Buckshot saw Cowles on the ground. His brother and another roommate came running and called 911.
Everybody was asleep, so everybody just kind of woke up and was confused on what was going on. I called his name twice, and he was just staring up at the ceiling. I thought he was already dead, and then I looked at his stomach to kind of see if he was breathing, and he still was very slowly taking breaths.
But Cowles didn't make it. Police took everyone in the home downtown for questioning and termed a woman a person of interest. They later released them without filing charges. Buckshot didn't want to comment specifically on who pulled the trigger and why.
I could speculate all day, but I'm not a trained homicide detective, and I'll just kind of leave that to the cops. Everybody's still really shaken up over what happened, and it still really hasn't sunken in.
Again, the case now goes to the Commonwealth's Attorney's Office for review and recommendation. Reporting live outside LMPD headquarters, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.